An historic day for Sydney commuters, with the first passengers riding on the Northwest Metro line. The public, though, will have to wait until May, and that might be too late for Premier Gladys Berejiklian to win any extra votes come Saturday.
The first ride on Australia's first driverless train.
We're off.
The Premier's pet project, on time and under budget.
Never ever has that happened in the history of New South Wales.
The Northwest Metro running remarkably smoothly for speeds of up to 100 kilometres an hour, as Shadow Transport Minister Gladys Berejiklian came up with the plans 9 years ago. Today, as Premier, she was one of the first passengers on board.
I can confess that it was quite a sentimental moment.
Over the Skybridge at Kellyville, testing the technology, a window where the train driver would normally be. As close as the Premier's going to get to cutting a ribbon before Saturday's election.
What we've experienced today is a taste of what people will get, and I think they'll be blown away.
The Turn Up and Go service runs from Tallawong to Chatswood. Tunnelling has already started on the second stage of Metro, linking the line at Chatswood under the harbour to the Inner West, meeting up with the existing South West Rail line, which will be converted to Metro under the Coalition. The line is working, but it's still in the testing phase, meaning voters won't benefit from it until after they decide what's ahead for the Premier. But trains on the existing rail network were delayed this morning with urgent signal repairs needed at Redfern, a familiar sight for people who use our ageing rail network.
The government wants to talk about, you know, more metros that might be built in another 50 years. People want the rail system fixed now.
Liz Daniels, Nine News.